Hey guys, Delta Canuck in here, and I got some Modern Warfare 2 for you. I'm playing Search and Destroy on Quarry. My class is the MP5K Silenced with Marathon Pro, Lightweight Pro, and Ninja Pro. My kill streaks are the 357, UAV, Predator, and Harrier. And in this video, first thing I say is mentioning PAX, since I'm going to be there this weekend. I'm driving down Saturday, and I'll be on the show floor on Sunday. Holy crap, Duke Nukem Forever is playable? Like, I guess we know how long Forever is. It's 13 years, which is funny because then I've been alive longer than Forever. So, bad joke is bad. In this commentary I'm going to talk about Call of Duty Black Ops, since Treyarch did the full multiplayer reveal 2 days ago. It'll be 3 days ago when you see this commentary. Happy birthday to me. It was nice. I can dream. It was a birthday present from Treyarch. Another bad joke. I seem to have a lot of those. Anyways, a lot of this stuff has me really pumped. I'm loving the level of customization, the fact that the game looks, a lot more balanced. There are a couple things I'm kind of iffy about right now, but all in all, I'm psyched for this game. The new wager matches look really cool. That's something I definitely want to try out, though I'm going to have to get good at these new modes. For those that don't know, it's basically there's four new modes separate from, like, you know, your main multiplayer progression. They're called One in the Chamber, which spawns you with one bullet and three lives. One bullet in, like, a handgun and three lives. Then there's Gun Game, which there's 20 tiers of weapons, and the first person to get a kill with each weapon wins the game. Sharpshooter, which just randomizes the weapons like every 30 seconds or minute or something like that. And then the final one was Sticks and Stones, which gives you a crossbow, a ballistic knife, and a tomahawk. Now, I know if you were good with the throwing knife, you got some sick kills with it, but the tomahawk is so much cooler. It just sounds cooler. That should say it all. Like, come on. Then, you know, you got the insane levels of customization now. I love how you're really going to be able to progress through the game the way you want to, rather than being told at this level you get this and that and blah, 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 blah. With the new currency system, leveling up is going to be different. Instead of unlocking a gun at a certain level, you unlock a category of stuff, so you get, like, assault rifles at level 10 or something like that, right? And then from there, you can use the currency you earn in-game, COD points, and spend those to unlock, purchase guns and attachments for your guns and stuff and kill streaks the way you want to, in the order you want to. So it really, it allows you to progress through the game the way you want to, and allows for a lot more flexibility, which has me really pumped. And then, even with the guns, the level of customization, I mean, changing the dot on your red dot sight, putting custom emblems on your gun and on your call sign and stuff like that, it's just really cool. And in other games, like, I remember even Tony Hawk's Underground back on the PS2, I loved designing my own decks and stuff in the game. So bringing this new customization stuff, like the ability to put emblems and my clan tag onto my guns, I'm going to be spending hours just sitting there working on something and throwing it on my gun so it's really identified as my own. So if a guy kills me and picks up my weapon, he knows it's my gun, right? So it really just, it allows you to, even with, you know, the way perks are affecting you, tier 1 perks affect how you look. Like, so if you have Scavenger, your character's going to have a lot of ammo pouches. If you're using Ghost, he's going to have a ghillie suit on. It really allows you to create an actual identity for yourself, and there aren't many first-person shooters that do that because, you know, you don't see yourself. But the thing is, the other players do see you, so now they're going to be able to identify you, and I think that's really cool. It's completely new for a COD game. There aren't too many first-person shooters, like straight-up first-person shooters, that do that. The only games that really do that are kind of ones that have those serious MMO or RPG elements, like Call of Duty. Yes, they added in experience points, they've added in kind of that RPG element, but it's not like a Dragon Age or a Mass Effect or a MAG, since, you know, we're talking first-person shooters. It's not to the level of Meg, where you have this massively, this massive multiplayer game where you create everything for yourself, and the customization options in this actually look like it's going to be more than Meg, because really in Meg, you chose a face, you chose a voice, then kind of some armor. You still look the same as the guys on your team, but right? Yeah, but there'd be tons of other guys on the team, especially with 256 players, that would look exactly the same as you. So that was this, you know, face paints, your gun, like the outfit your character wears. This is looking really, really awesome, and I can't wait for it. I've pre-ordered the hardened edition of the game, and I have to say I'm psyched. I was all psyched about Medal of Honor after that last trailer came out, but now I'm thinking, do I need 2 first-person shooters this fall? I'm still getting Medal of Honor because that game looks awesome. And Black Ops looks like it might bring the respectability back to the Call of Duty franchise, because it took a hit from Modern Warfare 2. Sure, you still have all the 10-year-olds playing. Sure, guys like me are still playing it because you guys like the gameplay, and when you get a game that isn't infested with boosters or noobtubers or guys running around with tack knives and commando, it can be really fun. And, hell, just even if they left everything the same and then just got rid of one-man army, Danger Close and Commando like they've done in Black Ops, it would be miles, miles better. And all I wish for now, really, after seeing all this, is dedicated servers. For Christ's sake, get some dedicated servers on the consoles, because I hate this peer-to-peer crap post-migration. And I guess, you know, the other thing that kind of bugged me is Marathon and Lightweight being back. I was hoping they'd be combined just into extreme conditioning from World at War and COD 4, but they're back, and at least Marathon isn't unlimited sprint anymore, so that'll kind of help level things out. And, you know, they fixed a lot of stuff, like stopping power's gone. That was in there's a counter to Juggernaut, so if Juggernaut's not in the game, neither should Stopping Power. So it's kind of small things like that that cause balancing issues in Modern Warfare 2, and it's those small things that looks like they're going to be fixed in Black Ops. Like I said, the Tier 1 perks are going to be affecting the way your character looks. Tier 2 is kind of things that affect your gun, so you got Bling, which has been renamed to like Warlord or something. Sleight of hand, steady aim, that kind of stuff. And then tier 3 kind of affects like your player itself, so like ninja, hacker, stuff like that. Anyways, that's all the time I got. My final score is 16-2. We win the match 4-2. Game winning kill cam right there from me. Some rape with the MP5K, which is a gun I don't necessarily like that much. Anyways, I'm going to be on PAX Sunday, so follow me on Twitter @DeltaKanuckian for updates, and see ya.